So it's very important that you relax to these tests and some of the technical terminology. I'm going to provide you with lots of tingly terminology. Can you see the budgie? Can you see the budgie? Just follow the budgie. Follow this way. Right and left. You're doing very well. Excellent. Follow the budgie. Tell me if you experience any double vision. Do you see one budgie or two? Any double vision? Okay, excellent. That's the little budgie. This board for me. Can you see the duck? Can you see the quack quack? Can you see the quack quack? There she is, Mrs. Quack Quack. She's going to come a little bit closer for you. She's very good at helping with these technical. Mrs. Quack Quack. So I've heard that you want some magnification. You can have some magnification. We can acquire a magnified view at the front of your face, of your eyes. That's the way. Okay, just close your eyes for me, please. Very safe here. Okay, open your eyes now. I want you to look into my eyes. We've got this little device, this technical device for providing some illuminated magnification. Okay, we'll check the right eye and the left eye. Illumination combined. Looking right, looking left, looking up, and looking down. That is a fantastic illuminated and magnified view. And I think you've already met Mr. Model Eye. Mr. Model Eye. Side view, the cornea. Can you see the cornea? And the iris. And the iris. The iris is the coloured part. And this part of the eye is covered with the conjunctiva. Conjunctiva. It's a very thin, transparent membrane. And just rotating, we have the extraocular muscles. Can you see these muscles for controlling the eye movement? The extraocular muscles. And inside we have some other structures. We have the crystalline lens, we have the vitreous humor, and the macula, and the optic nerve. Telescopic viewing. Place the object here and we can change the magnification. We can change the magnification with this viewing device. And we also have some was that? I've been interrupted. To go somewhere. Where would you like to visit? Connecticut. The Model I would like to go to Connecticut. That's a little bit unusual. Why would you like to go there? Because they have good chocolate in Connecticut. Good chocolate in Connecticut. Maybe this kind of chocolate. Maybe you're out of your mind. Did you ride here on a zebra? I think you rode in on a zebra. Or did you come in on your Chevrolet? He came in on a stripy Chevrolet that looked like a zebra. Okay. I think he needs to go to bed. Okay, speaking of chocolate, we'll call this the viewing board. Do you like the ocular viewing board? Can you read what's on the chart for me, please? Have a closer look. Read what's on the chart. Excellent. Excellent. We're doing very well. Brilliant. So you can see what's on this somebody who can help with your double vision. We have the prism bar for eliminating double vision. Let's let the prism bar have a little look for any double vision. Double. Okay. Single. Double. Oh no. Do your thing, Mr. Prism Bar. Excellent, Mr. Prism Bar. He also brought these spectacles with him. These black spectacles. These viewing, ocular viewing. Wonderful retinoscope where we can do some retinoscopy. We can use the retinoscope with its wonderful sounds. This is the illuminating wheel. And just listen to the sounds of the retinoscope. Use the retinoscope. We are looking for with or against movements, positive or negative. You can swipe the light, looking for with or against movements, positive or negative, positive. And we have this little lens. This is the Volk lens, V-O-L-K, Volk lens. And this provides us with ocular viewing in a stereoscopic manner. 3D, stereoscopic. And looking up and looking down. Excellent work. with the lens or clearer without a lens? I think it's clearer with or without this sphere, using the sphere lens, with or without. Without. You want to do some cross cylinder to check your astigmatism. You can use the cross cylinder to check your astigmatism. Okay, looking straight. Am I clearer with lens 1 or clearer with lens 2? Clearer with lens 1 or lens 2? And again. Clearer with lens 1. Cylinder. Clearer with lens 1 or clearer with lens 2. And once more, clearer with lens 1 or lens 2. Or is it the same? I'll repeat it once more, lens 1 or clearer with lens 2. Fantastic. Are very technical tests, and we need to make sure there's no keratoconus. Let's do a little bit of retinoscopy, ensure there's no keratoconus. Okay. We certainly may have to do some more tests later to ensure there's no keratoconus. Affects the cornea. Keratoconus is irregular astigmatism. Okay, let's provide you with some extra illumination. Just close your eyes, please. I need to look at the lids and the lashes. Open your eyes, look to the right, look to the left, down and up. Excellent, fantastic, that's good work. We have the flipper lens, so let me just adjust this for you. Just adjusting this piece of equipment for you. Again, nothing's clearer with the lens or without. Clearer with or clearer without. With and without. Excellent. So I discovered this little scalp. Scalpel for making incisions. Scalpel for making incisions. It's a pretend scalpel. Okay. Are you doing okay? I just need to have a look at the notes. Any strabismus or amblyopia. I will check for strabismus or amblyopia. Just looking to the left so I can look at your ears. Make sure we check the pinna, the helix, and the canal. Pinna, helix, and canal. Look to the right. Your mouth. mouth for me. Let me check your tongue. And check your salivary glands. Up the glasses. Up the glasses. And then we have certain taste receptors. Bitter, sweet, salt, sour. Bitter, sweet, salt, and sour. Excellent. Just raise your tongue for me. And say, ah. Papillae on your tongue. I think we'll need some extra magnification to check the papillae at some point. The papillae. We also have papillae in our small intestines. Papillae. Right. So, I think we should have a little look inside your eyes with the ophthalmoscope. Device providing illumination. We have various filters. Okay, let's turn the lights down for you. Okay, I have a little bit of external illumination. Looking at the lids and the lashes. Looking up now, looking down, looking left and right. Okay, so I'm looking at the cornea. The cornea is very clear. Okay, and the crystalline lens. The crystalline lens looks clear. Check your optic nerve now. Let's turn the light down a little bit for you. Checking the optic nerve. Excellent. And we'll move on to the macula. Let's look at the macula. These are very technical structures. The back of the eye, very technical. They serve a fantastic and wonderful purpose. Cobalt blue light. Let's have a look with the cobalt blue light. Cobalt blue. You're doing very well. Excellent. I'm going to check your left eye now. Right, looking left, and looking up and down, and the lids and the lashes, and our glazians, and our styes, and our trichiasis, epiphora, negative for epiphora. Okay, let's go deeper, check the cornea first, it's external surface. Crystalline lens, look up, look right, left, down. Crystalline lens is clear. I look through a little bit further at the vitreous humor. Maybe there are a few floaters in the left eye. Maybe a few floaters. Okay. Check the optic nerve. And the macula. The macula. Fantastic. Let's switch to a red-free light. Red-free. Red-free green. Looking to the right. Looking left. Looking up. Looking down. I the illumination there. And give me a little bit of focus with the focusing. Very calm and collected examination, very calm and collected technical examination. So next time we may do some neurological tests on your eyes, some further neurological tests, neurology. So I think it's time that the prison bar said goodbye. The prison bar say goodbye now, and he will see you next time. The prison bar will see you next time.